Dramatic information as the murder trial begins in the case of an El Dorado Hills teen accused of killing his 14-year-old girlfriend's mother. KCRA3's Mike TeSelle is live from Placerville, where those new details emerged during this morning's opening statements to the jury. Michael?
Yeah, we're live right outside the old courthouse here in Placerville, and it was in there that we heard three pretty big things for the first time today. We heard that there were multiple confessions of murder that the defendant himself made, that the victim's own daughter is a liar, and that both teenagers said they wanted the victim dead. And all of these revelations, both sides admit, are true. Take a look. This is new video of Steven Colver. The judge allowed us to take these pictures in court this morning before the jury was brought in and seated. Cameras were removed from court before that happened, so we were able to get these pictures. Now, remember, Colver, as you said, accused of murdering his 14-year-old girlfriend's mother. Prosecutors revealed that Joanne Witt was stabbed more than 20 times as her daughter was in the fetal position just feet away. Prosecutors say the motive here was that Colver was discovered to be dealing drugs and that the mother also discovered he was having a sexual relationship she thought was inappropriate with her 14-year-old daughter. Prosecutors also revealed that Colver admitted multiple times, face-to-face and in text messages to friends, that he indeed did do this killing. And they say he burned his clothes in the fireplace after the killing because of it. However, the defense attorney for Steven Colver painting a very different picture. He said the only reason that he did confess to those friends was that he was trying to protect Tyler Witt for what she did before he even got there. In fact, in the weeks right before this murder, the defense attorney says Tyler Witt was caught threatening her mother with a knife. And he says that Tyler Witt all along has been lying about what really happened to the point of calling her a quote-unquote pathological liar. So very dramatic moments in court this morning. And through it all, this jury of seven women and five men, they appeared to be hanging on every single word. KCRA 3 will stay here bringing the latest details on the night's evening news and on KCRA.com. Live in Placerville, I'm Mike TeSelle, KCRA 3 reports.